prevent black marketing of fertilizers, government would also offer adequate subsidy to farmers who adopt greenhouse cultivation methodologies. The government will set up a sugarcane research center in Nizamabad and a turmeric research center in North Nizamabad district. A horticultural university will also be set up to strengthen the agriculture sector. I am proud to inform that 1/3 of the nation's poultry industry is located in Telangana. To further boost this industry, incentives will be provided to entrepreneurs and farmers to take up poultry farming on a large scale. Telangana Kaveri and Krishna, whose tributaries and streams crisscross the state. We have to make full use of the water resources across the state to increase the overall irrigation potential and bring lakhs of acres of parched land cultivation covering 1 lakh acre in each and every assembly constituency which is dependent on agriculture. To reach this target, my government will focus on completion of all pending projects expeditiously. The government will persuade the central government to accord national project status to Prana Hita Chavala project. My government proposes to take up Paramur to cater to irrigation water requirements of western parts of Rangareddy district, in addition to supply of drinking water to Hyderabad. The Jurala Pakala gravity waters flowing through Gurmagadda in Mehboob Nagar to Pakala tank in Warangal, passing through Mehboob Nagar, Nalgonda and Warangal districts, will help to irrigate these regions. An immediate survey will be taken up in order to establish the above mentioned irrigation system. My government will give due emphasis on minor irrigation in entire Telangana, laying particular emphasis on restoration and strengthening of chain link tanks, aniquets and ponds facing power shortage. Thermal power installed capacity is 2,283 megawatts and hydro power installed capacity is 2,157 megawatts. In order to improve the situation, it is planned to take up the issue with the Government of India to fulfill the commitment made under the State Reorganization Act to set up a 4,000 megawatt power plant by the NTPC. Requisite land and water will be provided by the state government. In addition, through the private sector, we plan to generate 6,000 megawatts through GenCo. We will establish on a war footing the requisite grid lines and distribution networks in order to purchase and supply power from the state of Chhattisgarh within the next 3 years. With all these coordinated efforts, we will make Telangana a surplus power state. As parts of efforts to tone up public health, my government will establish super speciality hospitals in all the districts. Adequate bed capacity will be added in all primary and secondary level hospitals. The existing 108 and 104 services will be strengthened and operationalized. Telangana will formulate the best industrial policy which will give the required boost to the economy. A model system of single window clearance will be put in place. A special chasing cell, SCC, will be attached to the Chief Minister's office to give speedy clearances to the upcoming projects with zero corruption and no harassment to potential investors. We would like to establish a cotton and silk hub in Warangal and Sirsila on the lines of Tirupur of Tamil Nadu, which will transform these towns into thriving textile industrial centers. An industrial corridor will be promoted in Hyderabad and Warangal to boost employment opportunities. We will pursue with the Railway Ministry to set up a rail coach factory at Kazipet, as mentioned in the 13th schedule of the State Reorganization Act. The objective of all the foregoing measures is to not only achieve rapid progress in industrial areas, but also provide employment opportunities to lakhs of unemployed youth, in turn strengthening the state economy. Hyderabad city, the capital of Telangana state, has more than a 400-year-long history. People from various parts of the globe and India have made Hyderabad their home, making it a cosmopolitan city where diverse cultures thrive. It is for this reason that this city is described as the city of Ganga Jamuna Tehzeeb. My government would like to transform Hyderabad into a world-class city with a distinct brand image. Various steps such as cleaning and protection of the Musi River and other water bodies of the twin cities will be taken up. In addition, basic requirements such as piped drinking water, underground drainage systems and stormwater sewage systems, scientific collection and clearance of garbage will ensure control of pollution and maintenance of sanitation, leading to a clean, green, pollution-free Hyderabad. We will strive to make Hyderabad a slum-free urban conglomerate by establishing planned site-specific master plans, which will accommodate those proper poorer sections and migrants who come in search of a better future to the city of fortune, Bhagyanagari. To make it a delight for any international traveler and for local residents, facilities like expressways, rapid mass transport systems, domestic airports are planned to be undertaken strictly as per a visionary master plan prepared in consultation with international agencies, incorporating the best of the most livable cities of the world, such as Melbourne, Vienna, Vancouver, Toronto, etc. In short, my government's vision for Hyderabad is a city of stability, good health, care, culture and environment, education and infrastructure. The face of IT sector will be transformed in Telangana with the implementation of the prestigious Information Technology Investment Region project in Hyderabad. In all, rupees 2.13 lakh crore investment will be channeled into various units in the state, opening 52 lakh employment opportunities for our youth directly or indirectly over the next 10 years. A skill development authority will be set up to provide gainful opportunities in the expanding economy. I am proud to inform this August House that Telangana contributes to one-third of the pharma production in India. Further boosted, my government will lay emphasis on expansion of existing pharma, biotech and other industries. We wish to promote a pharma city as one of the satellite townships which will have government-run effluent treatment services to have complete pollution management. This will attract further investments in this sector in the coming years. In order to make Hyderabad a safe zone and an attractive investment destination, law and order will be the top priority for my government. There will be constant surveillance with a network of CC cameras and other advanced technical gadgets covering the entire urban agglomeration to make it a safe city on the lines of London and New York. Any offense detrimental to the interests of the state would be dealt with by an iron hand. Those responsible for any kind of disturbance or disorder in society would be taken to task without fear or favor. My government is of the view that better governance is possible at the field and village level if the elected public representatives, particularly MLAs and MPs, are easily accessible to people. To facilitate this end, we propose to take up construction of permanent office cum residence in the respective constituencies. This arrangement will enable people to access their MLAs and MPs in times of need. Keeping in view the spirit of democratic governance, my government advisory council, drawing its expertise from the civil society, moreover, intellectuals, media representatives, volunteer organizations, social activists, various professionals and others will be part of this advisory council. Chivariga, Bharata Rajyanganiki, Lobadi, Telangana Rashtramlo, Nilustunna, Prati Pauraniki, Samana Hoda, Rakshana, Kalpistamani, Nenu Hami Istunnanu. Sarva Jana Hitaya, Sarva Jana Sukhaya, Ide Telangana Rashtra Prabhutvam Lakshayam, Ashayam, Jai Hind.